heard people say that. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. We thank God for being here. We are so glad that you can share with us this morning. Amen. We are the Straightway Church of Christ, written in heaven, located in Belgrade, Florida. Amen. Where the Apostle Pauline Johnson is the pastor.
Amen.
Where God is truly in control of everything.
Amen.
Come on and tell God thank you. Amen. Those of you that have prayer requests, you may send your prayer requests in. Amen. And please notify us that you are watching and that God is blessing you. Amen. We thank God for his goodness. Amen. And we thank God that we are here to give him all the glory and honor to him today. Amen. Come on, tell God thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I'll say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. And when your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I'll agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. Together once again. Amen. And to thank God for his goodness. Amen. And to come together. Amen. To bless the name of Jesus. Are there any prayer requests as we prepare for prayer?
Amen. My prayer request is that the Lord will just continue to bless the church and the church family. That the Lord will continue to act in the church as he sees fit. That the Lord will continue to strengthen the saints here, there, and everywhere. That the Lord will our spiritual leaders, that he'll continue to build them up where they've been torn down and strengthen them where they'll be, that the Lord will touch the hearts and minds of our natural leaders as well, and praying and asking that the Lord will look on all those families that are dealing with bereavement at this time, that the Lord will just bring healing in the name of Jesus.
Are there any more prayer requests? Amen. My prayer request is that God will continue to bless his people everywhere. Amen. We're praying especially for our leaders, that God will teach us how to lead his people. amen, to be positive in all things, believing that God is and will do the impossible. Amen. We're praying, amen, for people everywhere, healing all over the land. Amen. We're praying for bereaved families everywhere. Amen. That God will just come in and bless us and give us what we need. Amen. We're praying that God will heal the land. Amen. Heal the people's heart. Amen. One thing about it, America got to repent and come back to God. And we're praying that that is in progress now. Let's pray one for the other. Amen. Let's pray for, amen, the body of Christ at large. Amen. That we will come together as believers and truly trust God. Remember, prayer can go and do. He can go places and do things that we cannot do. Let's pray for one another. Those are my prayer requests. Amen. We're going to ask Deacon Terrence Lovett to lead us in prayer. Amen. I need thee, oh, I need thee, yes, yes, every hour.
Holy Ghost in my heart. Oh, fire in the Holy Ghost.
deacon, different, love it, let us say man as he comes.
We're going to Psalms 37 chapter 5, the first verse. Do not fret because of evil men, or be envious of those who do wrong. For like the grass, they will soon wither. Like green plants, they will soon die away. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy a safe pasture. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him, and he will do this. He will make your righteous shine like the dawn, and the justice of your cause like the noonday sun. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret when men succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Refrain from anger and turn from wrath. Do not fret. It leads only to evil. For evil men will be cut off, but those who hope in the Lord will inherit the land. I read for you Psalms 37, chapter verses 1 through 9, if you edify to your soul.
The times of time ring out the news, another day is through. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you? You may have asked for added strength, your courage to renew. Don't be discouraged, for I'll bring the hope to you. It's a deep breath, what I can do. What he done for us, he'll do for you.
Get your
his goodness, his mercies to me.
Amen.
I just praise God for all things today. Amen. We're changing all the service. You can testify. Sing your songs. Testify your life to the honor and glory of God. Testimony service is open. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God? How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is thy God, and all see how great is thy God. How great is thy God, sing with me, how great is thy God, and all see how great.
Just another day. I think I perceived it back in 1963. Given minor space in the household of faith. He brought me down through years, through many trials and tribulations.
Thank you, Lord.
He stayed on the bond.
Thank you, Lord.
He destined the face many times, but he never left me alone. And I'm so happy for that. Give me the blessed Holy Ghost and a mind to run on. See what he ain't gonna be. I haven't always been true to him, but he've always been true to me. He never left me alone. Never let anything slip up on me. Pray that I'll forever stay meek and humble. And let my high place always be at the feet of Jesus. Thank God for the pastor, my wife, and Zionella, and my sons, and the bridge. Just thank God for everyone.
Amen, amen.
We owe him this praise. Let's give him the praise. Pray that God will keep us together. Keep us in unity, peace, and love.
Thank you, Lord.
That's what he's calling for, in righteousness.
Amen.
Then thank you.
Thank you, Lord. I'm living, just to please you, Lord. Oh, I'm living,
just to please you, Lord.
I'm living,
just to please you, Lord.
Let's
make the Lord.
Listen,
That please the Lord.
That please the Lord.
That please the Lord. Yeah.
Glory to God, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah to your name. Glory to God. We thank God, amen, for his goodness. Amen, and we must move on. Amen, time is certainly winding up. Amen, and we must be ready, amen, to go back with the Lord and do what the Lord has called us to do. Amen, and we thank God, amen, because truly God has been good to us. Amen, and we just praise him for, amen, what he's doing, amen, and how he's doing it. Amen, and we're trying to move on, and but it's so much happening in the land.
My Lord.
Amen. It's just so much happening in the world today. Amen. But we love the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. It's nothing too hard for him. Amen. And God is good, and we thank God for all of you that thought it not robbery. Amen. To be here with us today.
Amen.
Shine. Oh, oh, shine on me, lift the light from the lighthouse, shine on me, saints, let it shine. From the light, shine on me. I heard the voice of Jesus say, "Come on to me and rest, lie down, thy weak red one, lie down, thy head upon my breast." In the name of Jesus, give me what to say. Send your anointing. Break every yoke. God, some need one thing. Others need something else. But you, God, you know what we need. Have your way. Move by your spirit. Break every yoke. Loose everything that's back.
Yes, Lord God.
He's a little bit sick. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we look unto you. God, break the bondage in the families. Get out of every wall. Every, hallelujah, resentment. Break loose the grudges, the hatred. You can do it, God. You can do it. against the plagues that have come in the land. I speak healing. I lose healing now in the name of Jesus. Walk through this land. I speak life. Thank you, Jesus. Have your faith. Move by your spirit. Oh, bring every bondage, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Oh, God, from the White House to our house. Do it now, God. Do it now, God. Heal every heart. Heal it of us, God. Heal every heart, God. You can do it, God. It's nothing too hard for you. God, we're standing in need of prayer. We're standing in the need of prayer, God. I give everything to you, God. No matter what it is, my children, God, I give them to you. Make them over again, God. In the name of Jesus. God, have your way. Put a hand to, hallelujah. Put a hand around them, God. Because the devil is trying to sift the blame. God, hedge them up. Give them a love for you. Teach them how to do right, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Not only my children, but all of your children, God. Have your way. Do a new thing in our lives, God. In the name of Jesus. You can do it, Lord. Hallelujah. You can do it, God. You can do it, God. Come in today. Bless us while we wait. Minister to every need, God. Oh, God, those that are sick in their bodies. You're a physician that have never lost a case. Do it now, God. And we say thank you. But most of all, look on your word. Give us your word, God. And God, give us what to say. How to say it. In the mighty name of Jesus. These are your people. You know what we need. You know how to give it to us. And we thank you for it.
Thank you, Lord.
Have your way, moved by your spirit. And we say thank you. Everybody say thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Just have your way, God. Have your way, God.
Thank God.
Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. Have your way, God. All over the land.
Yes, Lord God.
Your way. Your will.
Yes.
Not ours. And we say thank you, God.
Yes.
We say thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we thank you. Glory to God. God, we thank you. We thank you for that.
Yes, Lord God.
We thank you for being God today.
Yes.
Glory to God. Amen. There's so much going on in us in this that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. So God then gave you control. So what you're worried about? Somewhere we now got taken away from the word. But we need to go back and leave it to the Lord.
Amen.
The whole earth is actually waiting with anticipation for the people of God to be revealed. Be revealed. They wait. They wonder where you are. What happened to you? There's nobody out there saying God can do. I got all power. I can do anything through Christ that strengthens me. Romans 8:19 through 21. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it, in hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. All we got to do is live. When we live it, speak it, and God will bring it into existence. The fourth rule, have dominion. You already got the control. The challenge is not in God. Having dominion begins when we gain dominion over our own spirit. Y'all hear that? You got to know how to control yourself, not somebody else. Proverbs 16:32. He who is slow to anger is better than the mighty, and he who rules his spirit than he who taketh a city. If you got control, you in better condition than any of the rest of them. God is preparing a people who will have the ability to rule with him in his kingdom. How can you rule with him? You can't do nothing down here. You need to give it to him. Revelation 3:20-22. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and dine with him, and he with me. To him who overcometh, I will grant to sit with me on my throne, as I also overcame and sat down with my Father on his throne. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit say to the churches. Overcoming is a demonstration of our dominion. Revelation 12:10-11. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his salvation and strength. Christ have come. For the accuser of our brethren, who accused them before our God day and night, has been cast down. Don't y'all know he throws Satan out of them? And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. And they that did not love their lives to death. You got to live the same. Singing and talking is all right, but you got to live the life by the day. We follow these rules because we are citizens of the kingdom. This is not our home. But we are citizens of the kingdom. Psalms 103:19. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and he rules over it. The earth and everything it belongs to the Lord. It don't belong to nobody else. It don't belong to Trump. It don't belong to Biden. The earth and everything in it belongs to the Lord. Psalms 24:1-2. The earth is the Lord's and all its fullness, the world and those who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and established it upon the waters. So everything here belong to God. And I'm gonna get it. What we got to do? We got to leave it to the Lord. And we got to let Christ rule in our lives. Kingdom citizens stand before the King to offer praise and worship, to receive blessings from His hand. Y'all know that's how we receive our blessings. How many know praise lead to worship? And when we really get in worship, do y'all know you can get anything from the Lord? Psalm 24:3-5. Who may ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who may stand in His holy place? He that has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted up his soul to an idol, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive blessings from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. Only way you're going to get it is you're in position to receive it from Him. We got to go to Him to get it. Nobody else can give it to us. Matthew 6:9-10. In this matter, therefore, pray, our Father, which is in heaven, hallowed be thy name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We got to acknowledge Him in all things. And when we realize that, leave it to Him, He'll give us what we need. Kingdom citizens are spiritually alive because of the breath of God. And that's according to Genesis 2:7. And the Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And man became a living soul. That's the only way you can become a living soul. God breathed life into you. So again, you have to leave it to Him. You can take it in your hands. You don't have control. And until we realize we have left God out of so many things, when we repent, go back and do it again. Give it to Him. He'll work everything out. John 20:21-22. Jesus said to them again, peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you. And when He had said this, He breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Ghost. That's the only way you're going to make it, if you receive the Holy Ghost. We told you some Sundays ago, if you didn't have the Holy Ghost, you couldn't make it. I don't care what denomination you're in. I don't care where you come from. You can't go to heaven unless you have the Holy Ghost. And that's the Spirit of Christ Jesus. His solemnity, it calls for sacrifice. Yes, of your wealth, of the money that you make, habits for unknown and perilous future. In other words, anything you give God 10% of. Let me say that again. Anything the Lord bless you with, you owe Him 10%. Then after all of that is done, we need His mercy. For none would have fellowship with the public. Yet Jesus offered Himself as the Savior and friend of such a sinner. When other people would have nothing to do with Matthew because of what he had done, he turned his back on his family. He turned his back on God. He left everything to get material things. Steal from people. And he was proud of it. But when Jesus came, he didn't tell Abigail what he did. He said, rise up and follow me. He knew, Jesus knew him through and through. He knew that God had mercy on him. So when he saw, for none would have fellowship with the publican, yet Jesus offered himself as a savior and friend of such as him. And if he did it for Matthew, he'll do it for you. It's promise apart from Christ. Matthew was on his way. Christ's call to follow him was a promise of salvation, fellowship, guidance, and protection. All he said is rise and follow me. He didn't make no other promises to him, but he saw him as a loving friend. Somebody that took time to come where he was. Come in that field. Right went to the station where he was working. Get up and follow me. It's light on transfiguration. Yesterday, Matthew was a companion of the saints. Today, a disciple. Tomorrow, a prophet of the kingdom. Can you say that for yourself? Now that God has brought me out of sin, can other people see the difference in your life, in your walk, where you go, what you say? Can they see cracks in your life? It's honor. The call testified to the way Jesus honored a sinner to become his fellow worker and an apostle. He went where he was. He wasn't so high. Some of us, I can't go this place and I can't do this and I won't do this. He saved you that you can save others. Sometimes we have to lower that standard and go where they are and bring them out of there. I have a friend, Mother Webb. I remember she had someone she loved. They was in the bar being mistreated, cast down or whatever. The cynic told her she couldn't go in there. Then the woman went right in there and got him out. Brought him out and prayed with him. Stayed until God filled him. So in essence, at the heart of the call, follow me, is the surrender to a person, not a group. When you tell people about Jesus, they're going to humble down and surrender. They're going to give up. Obedience to confession of and fellowship with Christ are all involved in the master's command. When he told him to get up and follow him, because he was obedient, God touched him. He forgave him of everything that he had done. He didn't bring him out no more. Some of us, every time you look, I remember when you did this, you said that. But Jesus said he threw it in the sea of forgetfulness. So at the call, you got to remember when he said, follow me, that means you surrender to a person, not a group, not a cult, not a race. But because you want to be a child of God, obedience is to confess and then your fellowship with Christ are all involved in the master's command. When you leave, you don't need to look back. What's ahead of you is better. What's ahead of you not going to get you in trouble. And if it does, God will get you out. We read that Matthew arose and left all and followed. telling his story. Matthew's main subject was the kingdom of God, which is mentioned 51 times in the Gospel of Matthew. The kingdom is ready to hear about Christ through you. The kingdom is like a fishing net, gathering people from every part of society. And that's according to Matthew 13:47. Offering new life and life-changing presence of God, according to Matthew 8:11. When you tell people or offer people something, you've given them something better than what they have. When you come to Christ, you have eternal life. And what I'm going to tell you about it, he consoled you right here on the earth. He said, I won't put no more on you than you can bear. Yes, you're going to have trials. Yes, you're going to have tribulation. But he said he'd go with you through everything you go through. So I'm saying to you today, he told you to rise up. Get on up and follow me. And when you listen to that command and take it to heart, the kingdom of God needs a rule, a reign of God in the entire universe. I don't care where you go. Your main conversation ought to be about God. It is a transformation of life, both individually and socially. A person enters the kingdom not by saying the right words, but by doing the will of God, which is in heaven. Leave it to God, and he will do the rest. I'm saying to you today, God is talking to somebody. Somebody need to walk away from what you are caught up in today. Leave it to God. And when you give it to him, the word says, oh, amen. All of it is already worked out. Amen. Once you give it to him, that's all he asks. Cast your cares upon me, for I love you. I care for you. Whatever you go through, whatever the situation is, he'll work it out for you. If you're sick, he'll position it and never lost a case. Yeah. If you're sensitive, he'll take care of that too. If you need a job, he owns the universe. Yeah. Whatever you need, leave it to him. If you give it to him, I promise you, everything will be all right. Leave it to the Lord.
After hearing such an awesome, straightforward message, the choice is yours. The invitation is now being presented to you. This same God, this same Lord that you just heard about, that came by the two brothers on the sea and the other two brothers, he's standing before you right now. The same call is being presented to you now. Follow me. Will you follow him today? Will you walk away from whatever it is that have you tangled up, bound up, or confused, and follow him? Would you just say to yourself, I tried everything else. Nothing worked out. But I'm going to step out and I'm going to follow him. It's not a hard process. When the call was made, when he told the brothers, to follow me. They just simply left what they were doing. Got up, put their eyes on him, and they followed him. Would you do that today? The word say that the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. You heard the word of God today. You heard the voice of God. Will you just come out? Don't reject the word. Don't reject what you're feeling inside. Because I know the word is tugging at your heart. I know the word got in your mind, troubled your spirit. Don't listen to the enemy. Remember the word. Follow me. Will you follow him now? Come unto him. Wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Lord, here am I. I heard your word. I desire to follow you. And if you have that spirit, you have that mind, all you have to do is just repent of your sin. That's to turn away in God of sorrow from the old lifestyle that you're living and make up your mind to follow Christ and the righteous standards that he set. And if you would do that, just ask him to forgive you everything that you think you've done wrong. And I want to serve notice to you. Nothing you've done is too hard for God to forgive you of. Just like God can use the publican, just like God used the fisherman, God can use you. Just surrender and come on over on the Lord's side. Wherever you are, whoever you are, if you prayed that prayer and asked with a sincere heart, that's what they, a true heart, you mean it from your heart. The word of God tells us that you are a new creature in Christ Jesus. You have been born again. But we also pray that God will lead you to a Bible preacher, Bible teacher, but most of all, a Bible living church home that you can receive the rest of the instruction to live this Christian and godly life. And we thank God for you today. And it's not hard. We give praise to God for touching your heart. And we thank you for surrendering to the call. All of heaven is rejoicing to all who have accepted Christ after hearing this awesome word. And those that will hear this word and surrender unto Christ. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Amen. And at this time, amen, we're going to bring to you from our very own Deacon Desmond Lovett Senior. Amen. As he come to you, let's be obedient. Amen. To his instruction. Not only be obedient, but let's be expedient. In other words, that means when the instruction is given, don't be slow about it. Let's get up about it and do it. Amen. For God is a timely God. Amen.
Let us say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for the word.
Amen.
Amen. Maybe you all just sit down and ask somebody else to speak. But when God moves, you have to move with him. Amen. Sometimes you don't feel like doing things or whatever, but when God speaks, you have to move. Amen. He said, leave it to him. No matter what's going on, give it to God.
Amen.
He gave you everything that you had. Gave you your wife,
yeah.
Your husband,
yeah.
Your children.
Yeah.
All of those come under God. Everybody agree with that? God is first, or should be first in all our lives. And if we haven't got it like that, we got to twist it.
Amen.
He comes first. everything else from underneath. If you put it in order, God give it to us. I guarantee you, He will bless you. Amen. So we say to you today, leave it to God. Take it to Him. It's nothing to our point. How many know COVID has come so close to us? Some of us even in our homes. But how many know God is over COVID? He controls everything in the earth. Speak peace, and peace has to abide. Amen? But we got to trust God. I don't care how it rage, how the storm rage, you got to trust Him. As we were saying, sometime before you can get out of one thing, something else is already there. But you got to give it to Him. He's able. Let's remember Pastor May, amen, the month of October, amen. He's on every morning at 10 o'clock praying. Amen. Let's pray with him that God will give them strength to go through. Amen. Praying for the people of God.
Amen.
And somebody got to stay on the wall.
Amen.
Amen. So we send to you, give it to God. It's too heavy, you can't carry it.
Amen.
Amen. Are there any announcements?
Amen. Let's remember for Sunday, set aside for to bless the music department. Let's be prepared to do that on Lord Sunday. Also, Stephen Terrence Love has asked that this month, amen, to raise fundraisers. He's asked his church family to be blessed him with $25 each by the end of the month. Amen. And we know that when we work together with one another, we can accomplish our goals. And if we work together, amen, when your month come around, amen, there's no question. Amen.
Amen. I see no birthdays yet, it's up there, but the 24th will be my son, Stefan Levitt's birthday. I don't know if we... The same day? That was Stephon's birthday also. Joe. I thank God that God gave him to me the time that he did. I thought it was impossible to live without him. And I thank God that he took me through that. That was one of the hardest things I ever went through in my life. But he proved to me he could take me through it. And he did. Some of you didn't know it, but all my children got, well, I think all of us have different personalities. You can have 100, but all of them got their own personality. Amen. He was quite in state to himself. Y'all know Desmond and Stephon and the Apple talking a lot. Amen. Being friendly. Amen. But Stephon was sort of set back, stay to himself. And I thank God that God gave me the time he did with him. And when God took me through that, I know he could do anything. Anything but figure. Because since I felt like I was going to die with him, I was going to go with him. It was a hard situation. But God let me know Even before he died, he told me he was gonna, die. He warned me. But I don't care what, how people warn you, you're never fully prepared. Amen?
Amen.
We saying to you all, love each other while you can. When they gone, they don't know nothing about you. Love them while you have them with you. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. No matter how stupid my siblings are, I love them. But that don't mean you put yourself in a place where you let them hurt you over and over again. I love them enough to stay out of their way and tell God thank you. Anybody can say what they want to say? I know I love the Lord. I've done everything humanly possible to get along with them. I believe the Bible said, fall at peace with all men as life within you. And holiness without. No man can see the Lord. When you've done all you can, that's all you can do. Amen. Amen. I don't have no quarrels, no hatred. A lot of times they come and say, you're still mad? No. God delivered me a long time ago from that mess. You can't be whole and got hatred in you. You got to love everybody. And when you do that, you have kept the commandment of God. Don't let people tell you you got to kiss people feet to get along with them. Love them and keep moving. Amen. Amen. Are there any other announcements?
Thank God for the service and my amazing word.
Amen. Amen. And we're happy to see you. Amen. Other Bridges in the house today.
Amen.
Amen. We're still praying that God will give her complete healing. Amen. And I thank God, amen, that when we came here to this church, Sister Mary and Mother Bridges were some of the first people we met here. Mother Bridges stayed here until God called her home. I'll never forget that Sunday that we did the dedications. And she said to me that Sunday, I can go now. This is what I was waiting for. And I believe Elder Bates and myself saw her. God took her as she left through that front door. We pray, God don't take her now. But that same week, she left us. She was a woman that loved and showed love. Amen. We're so grateful to God for all that He, the experiences that He's given us. And boy, we got some stories about some of these things. But guess what? He brought us out. Amen. I tell you, it's been a learning experience. But He brought us out. If there's nothing else, anybody else have anything to say? Let's pray one for the other. Saints, please, let's stay connected. Let's pray for one another. Pray for our children. Let's pray. Because there's so much going on in the land today. Amen. Amen. Let's trust God. Let's not forget, we got to give it to him. It's you and the folks. Give it to him. Give right now for the come. Our benediction.
Now, Father, I pray that you be a fence around us, protect and guide us, and lead us the way that you have us, Lord. That your Holy Spirit direct and guide us and lead us into all truth and righteousness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you and I love you.